Thank you, Mr. Chairman and Madam Ambassador. Welcome to the Foreign Affairs Committee. I've watched you in the short months that you've been ambassador. I hope you're enjoying my hometown of New York, best place in the world. I've watched you with admiration in terms of how you've been conducting yourself. As I said to you in the room before we started, we pride ourselves on this committee in being the most bipartisan committee in the Congress. The chairman and I have worked very hard to do that. Where there are disagreements, but we all share the same goal. And of course, the United States is the world's biggest superpower. We believe that we have a lot to offer the world and want to continue to work with all the countries of the world. I was disappointed in the budget. I said this to Secretary Tillerson as well. It cuts our support for peacekeeping efforts in the United Nations by nearly 40%. Peacekeeping missions help people who have been driven from their homes by atrocities in South Sudan. UN peacekeepers are now protecting nearly 250,000 civilians in places like Liberia and Cote d'Ivoire. Missions are scheduled to close soon because they've been so effective in building stability and security. We are traditionally invested a little more than the minimum required in peacekeeping, and that's what I think an indispensable power should do, which is what we have done. That's to show the world we're a big-hearted country that wants to see people all around the world live healthy, prosperous lives. American personnel are not deployed by these efforts. Our men and women aren't put in harm's way. These initiatives help prevent and resolve crises so that we don't have to intervene militarily, and they do it for 8 times less than it would cost to send an American soldier. So burden sharing, I know there's been talk about burden sharing. I believe these efforts are the definition of burden sharing. The administration's also seeking to completely eliminate American support for the UN Development Program, for Disaster Relief Coordination, for UN Women, for the UN Population Fund, for UNICEF, support for children living in the most desperate circumstances, 100% reduction. I think that needs to be changed. The UN has its problems. No one disputes that. We talked a little while about some of them. I personally think the way Israel is blamed and bullied by UN members is terrible. As I told you before, the so-called Human Rights Council has the worst human rights abusers on that council, and it is the epitome of gall, or chutzpah, as we say in New York, to think that they can sit look at anybody in judgment of anybody, given the fact that they have the most abysmal human rights records on the world. In the world, it almost makes it a little bit like Alice in Wonderland. But I do think American leadership is urgently needed to help shape Security Council resolutions and initiatives at other UN bodies, and when appropriate, use our veto to counter this imbalance. But walking away from our commitments isn't the right way to affect the reform that we all want to see. I believe these cuts would send a deeply troubling message to UN members that the United States no longer wants to be a global leader on a whole range of issues, that we're willing to cede the ground to whomever steps into our place. And I can't imagine a more harmful course. If we want our values and our priorities to be the values and priorities of other countries, then withdrawing from multilateral engagement is a grave miscalculation. And make no mistake, Beijing, Moscow, Tehran, and plenty of others would be more than happy to see us back away. So I'm glad that Congress will have the last word on the budget issues. I remain deeply concerned about the number of other areas where American foreign policy is going off course and how that affects our ability to work with other governments through the UN. I hope your testimony will address some of these problems. And let me say, as I told you before, I look forward to working with you. You have approached this job with a zest and a verve. It's been very refreshing. We will, from time to time, have policy differences, but I think we all stand for the same thing, obviously, and that's what we've tried to do in the Foreign Relations Committee. So welcome. I look forward to your testimony, and I look forward to your tenure as a UN ambassador. I yield back.
Thank you, Mr.